Welcome back, trainers. So we're going to be taking a look at two Vaporeon raids. They have made a return. And at the end of this video, we're going to be going over all of the new raids, okay? For now, let's go ahead and talk about this. So I only used two Alolan Exeggutors, Bullet Seed, and Solar Beam to take out this Vaporeon. The first time, it took me about two tries. The second time, it was my first time and one and done. All right, so my first one, level 40, my second one, level 35, okay? The level 35 one, I didn't power that up. I caught it just like that. The 91%, I actually powered that one up, and I made a video about it. So what you're going to do is dodge all of the charge moves. As far as the quick moves, you don't really dodge those, and you just, go to work on it. Now, if you have Sunny Weather, you will be able to use just one of these if you have it maxed out. I'm certain of it because I did a few practice runs other than my, the two fails where I was just going to see how far one Alolan Exeggutor can get by itself by dodging as much as I can, even some of the quick moves. And I was able to get it past deep in, I'd say like 35% health left, all right? It was well into the yellow. And unfortunately, I took an aqua hit or an aqua tail. There was a lot of shadow hits because when they have these double charge moves, it tends to shadow hit you more often, which is so annoying. Like, come on, Niantic, can you please fix the game at this point? And I know it couldn't have something to do with my service or my phone, but I'm pretty sure most of the time it's their server because it happens to a lot of different people that I know. Anyways. So if you have Sunny Weather, you should be able to do one of these with just one Alolan Exeggutor because you have double resistant, your Dragon and Grass. That's why this is a fantastic Pokemon to use against a Vaporeon raid. So as you can see, we're at 104 seconds and am I going to get it into the yellow? No, I wasn't even able to get into yellow. See, the first two times I got it into the yellow, but I knew what I was doing. And I didn't want to start over. I think there was maybe 3 minutes left on this raid. So I was like, all right, I better do this now or it's never, right? So the lower CP one, should I say? Yeah. The lower CP and percentage one did more damage because I dodged a little bit more. I do believe that's what it was happening. Dodged as many Aqua Tails as I could. I think I took one, but other than that, it was just straight up beast mode. As far as which one do I think will be the easiest to solo, the Aqua Tail or Hydro Pump or Water Pulse, I think it's probably going to be maybe Hydro Pump because if you dodge that, it literally does an inch of damage. Like, it's so minuscule, it's crazy. And if it does have Hydro Pump, the only thing you need to worry about is that one Hydro Pump coming at you, so you can just attack until you have a feeling it's about to hit you and then just dodge. So if I do get Sunny Weather, I will be using one of these. Now watch if there's people are going to start putting upload videos about this. Better do it quick. Unfortunately, there's not a cloud in the sky here. There's not one cloud in the sky, but in the game it says cloudy weather. So it should be sunny. So hopefully it will change within the hour or something, and then I will be able to try this out with just one. So I was able to beat it there. It was like 10 seconds or something, 9 seconds. And I'm going to do a lot better on my second one, well, because I know what I was getting into, and it had a charge move that only had two, as opposed to the one that just kept coming and coming and coming, and I had to keep dodging, which is taking time away from me to put damage into that Vaporeon. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at this raid here. One more, and if you want to give this a shot, I mean, go for it. Like I said, basically just dodge all the charge moves and you should be okay. As far as the tests on how many hits you can take with these type of Pokemon with these levels here, I was down to about, you can take one charge move, or you can take about two charge moves, honestly, but it would be very close. So best to only take one charge move. Other than that, you need to dodge the rest. So let's take a look at this raid. And after this, we're going to go over what we have currently in the raid system. So let's see what we have here. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed that, and if I get sunny weather, I'm going to be doing one Alolan Exeggutor versus a Vaporeon raid, which is absolutely crazy to think about, because there's no other Pokemon that can do that. All right, so for tier ones, we have, these can all be shinies, all of these, possibility. Shellder, Magikarp, Omanyte, Kabuto, Whalmer, crazy, all tier ones can be shinies. Tier two, we have Tentacruel, Krokodon, Barstomp, and Mawile, which the only one being a shiny possibility is Mawile. Tier three, we have Machamp, Starmie, Vaporeon, and Sharpedo is an interesting one. Super weak, but it's so funny, right? That I made that Sharpedo video and now we have these raids. And same with before we had the Ninetales, I did the whole review of Ninetales and how good Solar Beam is. And then we get the Ninetales raid. It's pretty weird. All right, so tier four, we have Tyranitar, Aggron, Absol, Whalrin, and then that's it. So I don't understand what's up with Aggron. Like, what's the demand for? Do people really need Aggron that bad? Because that's been out for a long time. Tyranitar is a viable Pokemon, a useful Pokemon, a meta-relevant Pokemon. Aggron is not. And then tier five, you have a Kyogre, which can be shiny too. So trainers, I hope you enjoyed this video. That was pretty fun to do those Vaporeon raids, and hopefully I can find some more with sunny weather. Take care, and thank you for watching.